In this video, I want to talk about the idea of logistic growth. Logistic growth and a logistic model is maybe a more realistic idea of a population's growth than what we're used to, which is usually either linear or exponential. That's what we've typically looked at for now. So you can see here, I said 10 fish are released in a lake. They eat, they live, they spawn, they're happy. But at a certain point, you're going to start running out of food. And the amount of fish will maybe not decrease, but will level off based on the number of resources. So typically what happens is you start and you begin to grow, and as you get closer and closer to that limit, that carrying capacity, what we call it, you level out. Okay, and again, we call this limit the carrying capacity. The idea being that the closer you get to it, the more the growth will slow down. So this idea of exponential growth is probably not realistic. So an exponential equation had that differential equation. And what it was is simply saying that to figure out how much we're growing, we multiply by a constant. And if you think about separating this, you know, divide by P, multiply by DT, integrate, this is the continuous growth differential equation. And again, you could go through and actually do the separable differential equation. But that's not realistic, because the population shouldn't just continue to grow. At some point, the growth rate should be limited as the population gets nearer and nearer its carrying capacity. So that brings us to this. We start with the same idea. You can see this looks like the same thing. But we create this carrying capacity where we say, as the population and carrying capacity get closer and closer, this thing in parentheses gets closer and closer to zero. Meaning, as these two get closer, the growth rate, the change in population, will get multiplied by something near zero. It will keep getting smaller. And like I said, exponential, every time, you know, the population would just keep growing and growing and growing, because to figure out how it's changing, we simply take this constant, a constant that we're given, and multiply it by the population. So if the population gets bigger, we multiply by k, and the change gets bigger. So what happens is we just keep getting larger and larger rates of change. Whereas this, as we get closer and closer to the value of m, then the rate of change will get smaller and smaller, because it's getting nearer and nearer to zero. Okay, so the growth rate of a population P of bears in a newly established wildlife preserve is modeled by that equation, where T is measured in years. Now, the carrying capacity is always this number in the parentheses. And I always like to have it in that form. Sometimes you'll see it other ways. We'll talk about that later. But the carrying capacity here is just 100. Now, what's the bear's population when it's growing the fastest? Well, think about the graph of a logistic equation when it goes like this. You know, here's its carrying capacity. It will be growing fastest kind of at this inflection point where we change from concave up to concave down. That inflection point is always going to be halfway to the carrying capacity. So for us, that would be 50. So what's the rate of change? Well, we have an equation for rate of change, so all we would need to do is plug 50 into it and figure out how fast the population is changing when P is 50. Now, the last question says, solve the differential equation. Now, I have a different video that actually solves the differential equation, and I would urge you to go watch that. What I'd like to do is just maybe give the formula here for a second that I do in that video. And again, please go watch it, figure out how we get an actual equation. But it is P equals 100 over CE to the negative 0.8T plus 1. And you see, I gave you a condition here. I said that at time 0, the population is 10. So we could solve that. We could say, okay, 10 equals 100 over c e to the 0 plus 1. Well, doing a little cross multiplying, that means that c e to the 0 plus 1 is equal to 10, so the constant would be 9. Okay. So my actual formula would be p equals carrying capacity over 9e to the negative 0.8t. And again, you're going to have to watch the video to see how I came up with all that. But this would be the equation. So the nice thing is the differential equation simply tells us how the population is changing. This actually tells us at any given time what the population is. Okay? Again, go watch the video on how we come up with this formula. But let me generalize here. So the differential equation, a constant times p, would yield the continuous exponential growth equation. Okay, this is the exponential continuous growth equation. And this is simply saying that the rate of change is equal to k times the population. So as the population gets bigger and bigger, the rate will get bigger and bigger. This other new one, this represents the fact that as p nears m, which is the carrying capacity, the growth rate gets smaller. Okay? And what that yields is this formula over here. M is the carrying capacity. You see the negative mkt, so that's negative, and then carrying capacity multiplied by that k, that coefficient that they give us. And in both cases, both equations, A is simply a constant that we would be given some condition to solve for. In the previous example with the bears, that was the fact that at time zero there were 10 bears. So both of those, A is just a constant that we would solve for later.